snake bit me.
What?
A snake bit my penis, Rick.
Oh, no. I've got to suck your penis, Morty. I've got to suck your little Morty penis to get the venom out now.
What? But you're my granddad.
Oh, come on, Morty. Just one little suck. It'll save your life.
April 1st, 2017, Adult Swim treated Rick and Morty fans to the ultimate surprise. That's right, I'm talking about the time they premiered that season 3 premiere out of the blue, completely by surprise. We had just come off of a year and a half hiatus.
Wait, you think the fam is gonna rescue us? Tune in to Rick and Morty season 3 in a year and a half. Or longer.
It was amazing, and honestly, to this day, that particular episode is still one of my personal favorites of the entire series. You know, it was a grand old time, unless, of course, you were, that is to say, a Samurai Jack fan. Basically, Samurai Jack was slated to air a new episode around, I think, 11:30, 11 o'clock. But the Rick and Morty April Fool's Day prank lasted 4 hours, including taking up Jack's time slot. Oh, but that's okay, because people wound up hating that season anyway. I mean, I didn't. I still love the season. I was still happy on April Fool's Day, but you know how nerds are.
Someone has mixed an Amazing Spider-Man in with the Peter Parker the Spectacular Spider-Man series. This will not stand.
Anyway, that prank, it got me wondering. I'm sure it got other fans wondering, are they going to do anything for April Fool's Day in 2018? And lo and behold, they did. But it wasn't in the way that people wanted.
Get in the car!
Oh, Rick, I was asleep. I was having a little Morty sleep.
Oi, get in the damn car now! Get in here!
Why?
Get in the fucking car!
That's right, we got the surprise guest-directed episode, Bushworld Adventures. Directed by Michael Cusack, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, I seriously do, he's best known for his online parodies such as YOLO or 90s as fuck.
Remember the Windows 95 startup? It was all like, bling, bling, bling. Nah, dude, it was more like, bling, 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 bling.
Rick and Morty Bushland Adventures was an odd take on the show. Basically, the plot, for lack of a better term, revolves around Rick dragging Morty on another one of his wacky adventures. This time, the adventure appears to be getting a green cube from Bendigo.
What do you mean? Where are we going?
Morty, we're gonna go get me cube. We've gotta go to Bendigo to get me green cube. We're gonna go to Bendigo, Morty.
Oh, Rick, Bendigo? Isn't that 12 hours away?
Morty, check it out. I did some science to me portal gun. And now it's also a real gun.
And that's pretty much it. From there, it's just a very loose structure, an excuse to go ahead and just have fun. You know, they go to a gas station. They visit Uncle Barry. I never even knew they had an Uncle Barry.
I don't know these blokes. I've never met them in my life. Get out of the house.
Oh, Struth, Rick and Morty is over. Uncle Barry's off his bloody rocker! Help me, Morty!
Overall, it was an excuse to be stupid for 11 minutes. Yeah, this one was actually only half the length of a regular Rick and Morty episode, but I'm not complaining. I don't think anyone could have handled 22 minutes of this.
Morty, shut the fuck up! I'm gonna kill you today, Morty! You're actually gonna die!
It's out of context.
I'm gonna blow your head off!
Oh, Rick, please, this is a prank! It's not funny,
no.
Alright!
Wait one sec, we're gonna go get some petrol first.
That said, I personally loved the episode. You know, I was just happy to get a bonus episode. But some people didn't love this episode. You see, in my mind, I was just like, oh, okay, we're getting a bonus episode. It's a guest-directed episode. We get these all the time, you know? Adventure Time's done them. We got an April Fool's Steven Universe. It happens all the time. But of course, this is the Rick and Morty fanbase, so...
not everyone was as grateful to have a bonus episode as I was. Now, I'm sure I don't need to remind you of the guy screaming, Pickle Rick on the counter.
I want Szechuan sauce! Where's my Szechuan sauce? I'm Pickle Rick! Wubba-lubba-dum-dum! I'm Pickle Rick!
You see, I'm not gonna bring him up because he was just a parody. He was joking around. But you see, the things he was joking about were real. Like, that's real shit. The Rick and Morty fan base, you know, it's just... Oh my goodness, I don't know, man. It's crazy. Everything from the annoying, piddly little shit, like people shouting Wubba Lubba Dub Dub, Pickle Rick everywhere they go, to the extreme shit of the fan base where they doxed and harassed female writers because they ruined their favorite cartoon. And everything in between. I mean, there's a guy who stomped on a pack of Szechuan sauce, and not only did the pack of Rick and Morty fans swoop in and start eating this shit off the ground, but he himself started eating it. What even? What are we doing? So yeah, I don't need to tell you that the fan base is, they're a little loony. To put it lightly. You know, it was getting so bad that Dan Harmon himself had to speak out about this shit. And, you know, Dan Harmon's a fucking nutcase. I'm sorry, you know, I mean, I love the guy's work. I think his writing is really good, but, you know, I mean, the guy went on an Instagram rant because Adult Swim insulted the writing of Game of Thrones. He went on stage screaming because he apparently thinks that a third of Americans are Nazis.
We have gotten so bad that a third of our country has gotten there. 29% of the people are fucking Nazis. Let's face it, that's a minority. We can beat them. We have to say, I'm not a Nazi, though. Two-thirds of the country just don't want to be political. It's not politics to say you're not a Nazi. It's like taking a shit. You just do it. Or you explode!
So really, the only sane person you're gonna see when you enter the world of Rick and Morty is Justin Roiland, and he's a drunk maniac half the time.
I've got three things I have to do. Number one thing of my three list thing is...
Oh my god.
Here to explain this whole baby princess. Whoa, 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 whoa!
So, That's Rick and Morty for you. Realistically, I don't know why I expected the fans to react better than they did when Bushworld Adventures came out. You know, I was happy just because we were getting a bonus episode, you know? We've gotten April Fool's episode of plenty of shows before. I didn't see the big deal. It was a joke. I mean, Adult Swim pulls these stunts every fucking year. I mean, if anyone watches Adult Swim, you guys know they love trolling people. Remember when they aired The Room every year for like 5 years in a row?
You just chip, 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 chip.
And then after that, they played like 5 minutes of The Room, and then they switched it to Toonami for an April Fool's Day prank. I mean, you never fucking know what Adult Swim's gonna give you. Overall, you know, I've just always found the Adult Swim pranks to be a load of fun. So, yeah, I go to Twitter, I go to Facebook. What are people saying about it? Yeah, that's pretty much it. No, yeah, people were collectively losing their shit over this episode. I saw people bitching, saying they were, that episode was too stupid for me.
That episode did not have the typical level of intellectualism that I have personally grown accustomed to when viewing the television program Rick and Morty. Ergo, I renounce my fandom membership. I'm gonna move on to more sophisticated television series.
And in the even worse cases, you know, people were sending death threats to the creators. There were people who actually wanted the people who made this episode to die. Hey, Rick and Morty fans, you okay over there, man? Yeah, realistically, I'm never gonna understand these Rick and Morty fans. I understand the episode might not have been your cup of tea. I personally found it hilarious. It was just a vehicle for some silly, absurd humor. And, you know, really, if you're watching Rick and Morty, you need to understand. You're watching an Adult Swim show, okay? You're not that smart, okay? Get off your fucking high horse. Go read a book. Go outside or some shit, okay? A little cartoon is not gonna hurt ya. Anyway, what did you guys think of it? I personally loved it, but were you guys annoyed by it? Were you the people making death threats? Let me know down in the comments, and take it easy.